starting field position here. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Now Ryan down around the goal line. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand.
Over 1,400 yards last year for Jones. Just six touchdowns, but you know, of course he had the big 300-yard game. However, when he was blanketed with coverage, he always opens things up for other guys, doesn't he?
He does, and that's what's benefited Atlanta's offense. Other guys were able to step up. In 2016, Mohamed Sanu stepped up and had his best year as a pro. Austin Hooper, as a young tight end, really developed down the stretch. And Taylor Gabriel, who had come over as a free agent from Cleveland, he really flourished, actually led the team in touchdown catches. But there's only one Julio Jones, and you want to get the ball to him as much as possible.
Now Ryan on second down. It's caught over the middle. Hooper. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Flush to his right. Now on the run. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Falcons. Mohamed Sanu, 58 yards. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket. No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Now Wilson. Complete. Richardson has it. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight. And when this offense is clicking on all cylinders, the running back is in sync as well.
The focal point. Runs, catches, blocks, sets the tone for the offense.
Now Wilson on second down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Tyler Lockett was the target there.
Here's a look at the young Atlanta Falcons, although next year, obviously, everyone will be a year older. So rookies like Deion Jones, Keanu Neal, Devondre Campbell, an extra year, well, their only year, but a year under their belt now to get better.
They're just young and growing, aren't they? I mean, I expect their play to continue to accelerate and elevate. But think about the building blocks they had in front of them. Second-year guys in 2016 who had big years. Grady Jarrett, a monster in the Super Bowl, tied his sack record in that game against New England. And Vic Beasley led the NFL in sacks for the regular season with 15 and a half and also had six forced fumbles. Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
On second down, here's Wilson. And the grab made by Doug Baldwin. Baldwin coming off his first Pro Bowl appearance. He had career highs, Charles, in catches with 94, over 1,100 yards. That also a career high. Pretty good season for Doug Baldwin.
And I think the place that he really started to take off was midway through 2015. The connection between he and his quarterback, Russell Wilson, where they were playing more from the pocket, bigger plays downfield, that just propelled him into 2016. That, and anything he perceives as a slight, he uses it to his advantage, and he just goes out and plays.
Earlier, partner, when discussing Russell Wilson, you said you think he's best when Seattle is running back-centric. Is Thomas Rawls the centerpiece going forward there?
I think so, because of what he did two seasons ago before he got hurt. Because he runs that offense the way they want it run. One cut, downhill, get upfield, and Thomas Rawls is perfect for that. If he stays healthy, That allows Russell Wilson now to throw the play action to bootleg passes that really hurt other teams defensively.
And Rawls has youth on his side, just 23. Ninth play of the drive now on third and a country mile. Third and long, it's Wilson being chased out left. And he's got Lockett. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory. Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
And now for the offense. This is play number 11 here on this drive. Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on third and six. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
That's caught at the three. No gain there on the completion. It'll be second down. But he caught it right at the line of scrimmage. And before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch. And most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
And the seemingly endless drive continues. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two, and they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Second down, Wilson. And he's going to score. It's a Seahawk touchdown. Russell Wilson taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
There are so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day, get the blocker away, and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
And finding the tight end, Hooper. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential. But when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Here we go on fourth down with Ryan. And it's complete. Hooper. 13 yards on the pickup. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
And the catch is made by Justin Hardy. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone. And when you watch Devontae Freeman run the football, you can almost close your eyes and hear him running the football, can't you? Because people just scatter. I mean, you know, when he goes through a pile, it moves in a positive direction for him. I just love how hard he plays the game.
1,000-yard season. He had 11 touchdowns last year. In March, 25 years old. So he's kind of hitting that sweet spot for a running back, isn't he?
He really is. And I still remember the evaluation of him coming out of college. He does everything well, but you weren't sure he had a dominant trait. Well, wrong about that. He's dominant just about everything he does. And I think that he's going...
It got his man complete. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, 43 yards. And the Falcons have taken the lead. Uh-oh, flag comes out here. This is going to be roughing the kicker.
When you're going back there on the kick block, you've got to go to the right point. That didn't happen. Ran into the kicker. The penalty flag had to come out.
Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to CenturyLink Field after this. They'll come out in the pistol. Shift together here from the D-line. Now Wilson. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted out of Stanford, and plays like a number one receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great. He's the one that typically comes up with the football.
Absolutely. His roots go all the way back to Gulf Breeze, Florida, where he's from, right on the water near Pensacola, and then, of course, to Stanford, and boy, he's been good. Little lull in the action here to go over an offseason storyline. It's kind of interesting. L.A., a couple years ago, they have no teams, and now they're going to have two with the move from San Diego to L.A. What does that mean for the league and for the Chargers?
It seems like an easier transition, doesn't it, than St. Louis when they moved back to Los Angeles.
Looking for Lockett, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford, and the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field, and that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
Man, it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Now Ryan on second down.
finding time. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was looking for Mohamed Sanu there, and now it's third down.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That would be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky. It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. They'll indeed go for it with Ryan. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm here, my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
After the interception, here's Wilson. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. All right, different topic here. 2018, the Super Bowl, traveling north, far north to Minneapolis. Early predictions for that one. Who you got?
Well, you know, everyone's still waiting in the NFL for a home team to play in its home stadium, right? So could the Vikings be that team? I'll start in the NFC, and I'm going to say no. I think Seattle. Starting to get near that maybe last run with their defense. Earl Thomas returns. I like Seattle coming out of the NFC. How about you?
Well, I'm actually going to take a Dallas Cowboys NFC title run. I think that they came so close this year, probably most talented going into next year.
I like that one. Well, in the AFC, I'm going to go with a team that if they improve their defense and their quarterback stays healthy, they could be that team, the Oakland Raiders.
Okay, I'm going dark horse. Cleveland Browns.
Let's go. Hey, from worst to first.
So on fourth down, as seen on TV, here's their resident strongman, John Ryan, on to punt. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. And it is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to launch this thing. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones. As the first half is winding down. And the Falcons will extend their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here. But I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all. Because if they don't, they almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Throwing is Wilson. Flushed out right. Now he'll let it go. That's caught inside the 20. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Tyler Lockett in the final seconds of the first half. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Final play of the half, it's Ryan. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Here's Wilson. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They'll give him 8 on the play, and they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Wilson now to throw on 3rd down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key 1st down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball, and the pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Grady Jarrett in there to get him his 2nd sack now of the afternoon. A 2nd down carry for ProSize. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. Able to pick up a healthy chunk of yards, 7-yard gain, but a tough 3rd and 9 upcoming. And they're going to speed things up here. On 3rd down, Wilson. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it, trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on 4th down and 9. 1 receiver left, 2 to the right. Here we go on 4th with Wilson. And Lockett with a grab over the middle. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. And they're going to go soft on the corners. On first and 10, it's Ryan. It's caught left side, Tammy. Give him a couple on the catch at second and 8.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Now Ryan on second down. And that's caught. Did he stay in bounds, though? He did not. Ruled incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this 3rd and 8. To throw is Ryan. Complete over the middle to Hardy. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. And now before this 4th and 2 play comes to fruition, they're going to think about it and call a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this 3rd quarter. So they'll say no to the 50-yard field goal try. Instead, the offense out there, they're going for it. They're going on 4th down. It's Ryan. It's caught over the middle. Hooper. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on 4th down.
Well, the field goal attempt was well in hand. They had that, but they decided to go for it anyway. Extreme confidence, it looks like.
Yeah, but I bet the defense is going to remember this one, right? They kind of rubbed their nose in it. Ryan, eluding the pressure right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
I'm not quite sure how he wasn't able to hold on to that one in the end zone. A great opportunity lost, but a lot of relief for the defensive guys. When they get into film next week, they're going to want to know what happened. Where was the breakdown that almost allowed a touchdown?
Now Ryan, and finding the tight end Hooper. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And quickly, they get to the line. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. Accelerating, and off he goes. The 20. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Now that was a beautiful play. A pick 6. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
What do you mean, with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
And out now come the Seahawks. Hauschka now for the extra point. And this offense, last time turned it over, went for it on 4th, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, there's no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good. But when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll try to get the ground game going with Freeman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills? And it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
Freeman again, a first down carry. And some room to maneuver. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
That's a good, strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
On second down, Freeman. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains. Back now in Seattle, Washington. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now the pitch to Freeman. And he's got some space here. It's a gain of 20 that time. And it'll give the Falcons a first down.
You got to feel a little bit for the defense there. They've done a terrific job all day long holding this guy in check. But that might have been the run to break things out for him, maybe turn things around. Now he's going to have some confidence, and maybe he'll get to his normal yardage.
Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because, really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Ryan. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
And a short gain here, down to the 22. Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down.
But forget knowing where the first down line was. This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front, and a lot of times that is one-on-one.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the All-Pro free safety, Earl Thomas. And he is going to be stopped on the return at his own 3-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. Now Wilson down around his goal line. Buying time to his left. And they'll get him down up past the 15. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
So here we go, first and 10 now.
Four down, check.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. A nice gain of 21 yards.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You
circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
Now Wilson on first down. And Graham's got it over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it. Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Wilson turns and gives to ProSize. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of two, now third down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed, and that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. On third down, Wilson. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Now they've got to be a little frustrated here to not complete that on third down after having such a long drive going.
Hey, you're talking about going over 70 yards on the drive. Yeah, did you say a little frustrated?
Very frustrated.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. Very frustrated. There's no doubt about it. They thought they were going to have a chance to cash in the end zone. Now it looks like it's likely a field goal attempt.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. And that is incomplete. The Seahawks go for it but can't convert. And the Falcons' defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having
And the defense loses him. It's complete. A big play there, Ryan DeJones, and even 60 yards. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
And now they're in the hurry up. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And as the fourth quarter winds down here, we're all even.
And no one wants this game to extend. They want to go ahead and win it right now.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. They were looking that time to get it to Justin Hardy. And it's third down. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route, you are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well come down with the football and absorb whatever else happens after that.
Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down. So an important try here from Matt Bryant. And the kick for the 41-year-old is up and good. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop. They're going to get out of here with a victory.
And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and ten. They'll look to throw. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. And all the way down inside the 25 before he gets out of bounds.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this. But run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
Fresh set of downs here. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. He'll look to throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So they're operating in the red zone. Another pistol look here. He's back to throw. Flush to his right. And he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages.
Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Yeah, I know only one of them counts, but this one looks like it's going to lead to a victory. I know we're not supposed to count anyone out, but with that little bit of time left on the clock,